Is she really going out with him?
Sister Cities is a real cool song. Girl, she's a real cool time. She knows how to make you feel fine. All the guys that hang around town know how Susie loves to sleep around. Sister Susie, she's a friend of mine. She likes it all, she likes 69. I like her hair, and she's got lovely eyes. She likes to put her head between your thighs. Never guess who wants a favorite game. She can play it again and again. All the boys will come back for more. On the floor, up against the wall. Sister Susie, she's a friend of mine. She can count right up to 69. Like her hair, but she's got lovely eyes. She likes to put her head between his thighs. She's so cute. Come on down, baby, I'll dance, you know. All right, we're all gonna be fun, gotta get down. Mom, Sister Susie, she's a friend of mine. Loves love, she likes 69. I like her hair, she's got lovely eyes. She likes to put her head between your thighs. She's a friend of mine. She likes 69. She's got lovely eyes, and she's a real cool
talking to Clint from Pop Will Eat Yourself at the Derby Warehouse. Okay, PWEI were previously Wild and Wandering, and prior to that, From Eden, or the other way around, whatever. How and when were you formed? Have you got any fond memories of all the first days and stuff?
Hate nostalgia. I think it's a completely redundant emotion, really. You know, you do what you do to try and get where you want to go. Basically, we just form bands, trying things, writing songs, playing gigs, learning. That's all it is.
Do you want to talk about Miles Hunt leaving the band and Graham Crabb joining? What were your first impressions of Graham Crabb? Nostalgia?
Those are two people who are my friends, you know. I mean, the fact that you can work musically with one person and perhaps not work music with the other does not really make them any lesser of a friend. It's just a different relationship.
Okay, your first singles were on your own labels. How did they come about?
Absolutely nobody was interested in us, so we had to put out our own record. That was it.
What about Chapter 22? What happened with them?
Craig, who's here now, after we'd put out our own single, he came and saw us playing Birmingham, and we came on stage to Bad Man by Cockney Rejects, and he absolutely loved that, and he just loved the attitude of the band, and that sort of like made us, or helped us hit it off as friends, and it's just been like that ever since, really. We're about the same age, we've got the same sort of background, we're into punk rock, we all liked the Banshees and Killing Joke and the Psychedelic Furs and the Sex Pistols and whatever, you know, and Bauhaus. That was where we came from. We all had like a similar background and we just got on as friends and it's just gone from there.
So you moved to, like, you got a major signing, London fell through, and then you moved to RCA, yeah? What happened there?
See, what people don't tend to understand is the fact that, like, relationships aren't made in heaven. You just go with where, you know, somebody who's prepared to finance your latest project, really. We just went with RCA because they were prepared to give us the money for us to do what we wanted to do, and that's what we did. And then when they were stopped doing, when they were no longer prepared to finance what we wanted to do, then we had to find somebody else to finance it. That's all that deals are. That's you know, be it independent, be it major, it's just about money, about being able to finance what you want to do.
You got moved off RCA. You know, what happened with RCA? How did it go sour?
I just don't think there was any fans of the band left there anymore. Major record companies seem to, like, have such a massive turnover of people working from, you know, they, you know, they're just always, like, excited by, like, the current vibe or whatever, you know. They're not interested in, like, building or, like, doing, you know, just working with something, you know. They just want an instant hit, an instant fix, and, you know.
They want the money then, yeah?
Well, I don't know what they want. I just feel kind of out of touch with them right at the moment, you know. They're narrow-minded is the bottom line of it, really.
Why did you get a beatbox movement going, like all the drum machines and stuff? What made you do that? Box frenzy and more evidently in This Is This?
It was the only exciting thing going on in music at the time, you know. We'd like done all this sort of like guitar-driven type stuff and we were kind of bored of it, really. Most exciting thing I'd seen in years was the Beastie Boys and Run DMC. And then when I heard Public Enemy on top of that, it was just blew us away, really. That was why we went for it.
Sending out a signal to cure isolation. It's called PWEI.